You guys just have such a spectacular view. What made you, you know, choose this spot?
And when we came across this location, we just absolutely fell in love with it. We really wanted to showcase not only the vineyards here, but also this traditional champagne method production. This particular vineyard, I was looking for something with a little more drainage. The variety that we have planted here is called a Frontenac variety. It's a French hybrid variety from University of Minnesota, and it grows very well in western South Dakota. And notice, especially soil types that are better at draining, they give it a little gentler, a sparkling wine, which we're looking forward to. Our first vineyard we planted in the year 2000 in Belle. We actually have more of a clay soil in the Belle, which is ideal for one of our varieties known as a Marquette. It really gives a heavier red wine.
Now, you are from South Dakota.
Yes, from Belle, South Dakota.
And then you left and went out to California to go to school.
I was initially at University of South Dakota in Vermilion. I chased my dream of going out to California. I went to California State University, Fresno, and they have an enology program where they have a 10,000 case winery that is student run.
It is very fun to go out there and, you know, tour all the wineries. And so what's special about coming to South Dakota?
There's such great potential with fruit that we grow here. We can make some world-class wine, especially our sparkling wines. We're finding that they're meeting that balance that they see in Champagne, France, with the acids and the sugars. And so for us to be able to grow that here, it's just exciting. We only do the traditional champagne method here.
Oh, okay.
And that's why we call it the sparkling house. It has to be fermented in the bottle. We do have a bottle that is in the first step, that is the neck freezer. We have to trap that yeast so we can shoot it out.
Okay. And then how long has the sparkling wine been in this particular bottle now?
This wine has been aging since July of 2014.
Oh, wow, okay.
And this is a state brut, so it's required the 3 years.
And I see how right there's about 2 inches of frozen, that's the yeast that's all frozen.
Yep.
Okay. Oh, cool. Oh, look, yeah.
Little bit of ice. Got it out? Have to age a minimum of 6 months.
I think one of the great things about wine and cheese is that both of them you just open up and enjoy. So I brought from the eastern part of the state this cheddar and the Monterey Jack, both from Dimmock. And I know a lot of people enjoy Brie, and you kind of see it here a lot, which I thought, you know, you being a sommelier, and maybe you could share your knowledge about what you think about.
We have some Brie cheese in here. I would suggest to drink some with the sparkling wine, one of our Brut.
And then Brut being dry.
Yes, uh-huh. Sparkling wine term Brut means dry. Demi-sec means sweet.
Yeah.
This wine is a very delicate. You don't want overpowering with any stronger cheese, so that's why I like to choose the Brie.
And now we would go from like kind of lightest to heavier, mm-hmm, which would be mm-hmm. the Marquette.
Yeah, so I want you to try some our estate-grown Marquette, okay, with the cheddar cheese. We grow this 100% Belle, our Jackson Vineyard, we do that. It's actually the French hybrid grapes, so it has a very similar characteristic to the Pinot Noir. It has a very nice fruity and plum taste of it, but we also age with the French oak, so it has a very nice spice.
That looks good, yeah. Mmm, yeah. Well, really well. Yeah, this is great.
And the Monterey Jack cheese, these are really easy cheese, I would say. I can just pair that with the Chenin Blanc, we have it here, or people probably familiar with the Sauvignon Blanc.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Every year there's another winery opening up in South Dakota, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. Thank you,
yeah,
very
thank
much.
You.
Yes.
Cheers.
Yeah.